Hi there, it's Gerry Andrews here, Body Mind Coach, and I just wanted to jump on here quickly to show you a couple of exercises which are really, really good for the piriformis and the glutes. So whenever you've got the sort of tightness in the back here, the lower back, but also it might feel a bit of pain and stiffness and tightness in the glutes as well, in this area here, and down into the hamstrings, then there are a couple of really good stretches which are good for that, which basically, if you're getting down onto the floor, and one of them is to cross one foot over the other knee so that you've got your legs like this, and then grabbing your knee with through your elbow so you can gently pull your knee towards your chest and really sort of breathe into that, relax into that stretch, but just pull that knee in towards you and hold that. So you want to be holding this for at least 30 seconds, if not longer. And the longer you hold it, the longer you breathe into it, the more relaxed and softer your muscles can get, and the better the stretch. So you're wanting to start to feel a good pull down through the back of the leg, back of the bottom area into the glutes, and that's really what you're aiming for. So you can do that on both legs, that's really important. And the other way to do that is a similar type of exercise, but this time you're lying on your back, and if you bring your knees up, I'll show you this way. And basically what you're doing, you're crossing one, I'll show you this way, you're crossing one foot onto the other knee, so that you're making almost like a figure of four. And then what you're doing is you're lifting that knee. So what you can do is grab underneath your thigh, at the back of the knee, and pull that towards you. So again, that gives you a good stretch running through the back of the leg and in through the hip. And the more you can actually open out your knee, let that drop down and bring this back, the other one back, then that's a really good way to stretch through that glute area. And that's a piriformis stretch. The piriformis is a little fan-shaped muscle which connects the top of the leg to the bottom of the spine, and that's the thing that is really quite tight, and that's where you're getting a lot of the tightness and stiffness through the hips. One other really useful exercise for your lower back especially is just to get into a position where you can relax all those muscles, so soften all the lower back area. And a really, really good way to do this, it's very, very simple, and one of the things that you'll like is just to find a chair or a settee or something this sort of height, and simply lie on your back and make sure that your knees and the bottom are at right angles this way, and you can rest your calves on the bottom of the chair seat. And all you're doing is that you're just breathing in again, just nice and relaxed. And just let all your lower back here just soften into the ground. So you don't want to try and arch it, you don't want to try and tense it too much. But just breathe and just let that lower back area just relax and soften into the floor. And just lie like this with your legs up for 10, 20 minutes or so. And that just helps to just ease the back. And you could be reading a book, watching TV, or listening to the radio or something, just so that you're quite relaxed through your body. So those are really good exercises for all of the glutes and the lower back area. But one final one, which we've talked about before, if you've been coming to see me, is to get a bit more of a stretch. And this is more of a dynamic movement, where we're doing more of a little bit of an exercise into this. So this is where we're doing a knee to elbow stretch. So it's the opposite knee to the elbow. And you're doing it nice and gently, nice and slowly. And you really want to try and get that movement going across your lower back, across your legs. And you can start to then just turn a little bit more into it if you want to try and get a little bit more of a through stretch through your back. But it's that diagonal movement which is really effective, and it just helps to keep your lower back and your hips quite mobile and flexed. So a few things there, and give those a go and see how you get on. And hopefully you'll start to feel a little bit more relaxed through your core, through your hips, and into the glutes as well. Okay, see you soon.